What's up, rock stars? Rikki Roxx, God of Thunder, Lord of Rock and Roll, coming at you. Sunday, just got done with the shoot job. Wanted to a little straight talk with you, a little straight shoot. You know, because we have a lot of fun together, but you know, some things are not funny and they're not worth joking about. We're gonna get serious for a minute. Lance Storm style. You know, I'm sitting at the shoot job getting paid a phenomenal amount of money. On my downtime, I'm just doing a little Facebook scrolly, you know, old man social media. And, you know, I see a lot of funny stuff, a lot of people having fun, but then I see some stuff that really pisses me the fuck off. Can't help it. It's gonna be one of those kind of things, you know. It's June. A lot of people out there being proud of who they are, having a good time, trying to anyway. It seems like there's always some fucking idiot who's got to run their fucking mouth way, way too much. You know, I see people out there trying to bring each other up, keep each other standing straight. Maybe a lot of people struggling through some hard times. You know, people like to come together and help each other do that, but there's always somebody saying something vile, horrible, something that I personally think makes a mockery of our First Amendment rights. I don't know what else you'd call it. You know, I'm seeing teenagers and children talk about some of the struggles they're going through. And for every bunch of people telling them to hang in there and be who they are and all that, there's always one or two scumbags saying stuff like, you know, you're sick, you're twisted, you're diseased. Yeah, even people telling them to go ahead and take themselves off this planet. You know, I think it's those people who maybe need to be shot out of a rocket straight into the heart of the sun, because I have no patience for that shit. Never have, never will. In case there was any doubt about how I feel about that kind of garbage, well, I'm gonna tell you right now. And if you got a problem with it, you can tell your fucking story walking. You know, the fact of the matter is, I wasn't always this super popular, super confident, super suave and debonair God of Thunder. You know, once upon a time, I was just an itty bitty little rock star, just trying to go to school, make friends, have a good time, be who I was, you know. And because I was little, real little, small, skinny, soft face, you know, I got picked on a lot. I got asked pretty much from the first day of school until I was about 11 years old, all the time, are you a boy or a girl? Because, you know, my hair would be a little shaggy sometimes. You know, I have very smooth, effeminate features, I guess. I look a lot like my sister, not gonna lie, you know. Got picked on a lot for a lot of reasons, but the ones that maybe hurt the most were those, you know, getting asked all the time if you're a boy or a girl really sucks. It's annoying. It's stupid. It really gets on your nerves. So this ain't new shit, believe me. And, you know, a lot of fights happen on the playground over gay. You're gay. And, oh, man, you like, you know, He-Man. You must be gay. And, you know, they would love to circle around, gang up on you, push you around, call you the F word over and over again. You know, not going to say I never did to anybody else. I have. Times have changed. People change. We all, if we're smart, try to evolve. You know, I'm a little bit of a different time when stuff like that was quote-unquote okay. Here's the facts. It wasn't okay. It ain't okay. It made part of my days miserable almost every day, even though most of the time I'm fortunate and blessed enough to say that I had a great experience for most of my childhood going to school. I did have a lot of friends. I'm not going to say it was constant torture and harassment, because it wasn't. I had it better than some kids. I had it better than a lot of kids today. But the fact is, when some kid knocks you down because you're little, or maybe you look like a girl or whatever, and they think it's okay to call you some slur because there's 10 other people watching and nobody wants to, you know, they're all laughing. And the teachers, you know, they tell you just get tough, get over it. It's just words, right? Yeah, it is, but you know, I personally decided if nobody else was going to do anything about it, I would. And I had the fortune to have the tools to put those people in their place real quick. And it never took me long. I gladly took suspensions for popping every idiot in the mouth. Every stupid asshole who thought it was all right to push me down or get in my face or call me some filthy name, that's what they got. And I would tell them, if you're not going to shut them up, I'm going to shut them up. And I always did. And I always will. That hasn't changed. You know, one thing I'm really fortunate about is when I was growing up, my parents never tried to force me to be them, never forced me to be anything I wasn't, never told me who I was or who I was supposed to be. They let me figure all that shit out on my own. You know, when I was real, real little, I mean, even people in my family picked on me and teased me a little bit because we'd come home from Toys R Us and I'd have, you know, He-Man toys in one arm and Rainbow Bright in the other. You know, and like my uncles or whoever, they'd ask my dad, what are you buying them that shit for? Don't you think that's gonna fuck them up? My dad would look him right in the eye and he'd say, that's what he wants. You want He-Man? You want Batman? You want Superman? You want Rainbow Bright? So, fuck it. He asked for it, he got it. Never made me feel bad. Never told me I was stupid or wrong or gay or any of that. Just let me like what I liked. The fact of the matter is, I probably had about as many Rainbow Bright golden books as I did He-Man golden books. They were all pretty cool. You know, by the way, speaking of Rainbow Bright, they need to bring that cereal back. That shit was awesome. But anyway, point is, for all the problems I had at home with my parents and all the tension we had, that was one thing that was never a point of tension. They never, ever tried to make me something I wasn't or lead me into what I was supposed to be as a boy or as a kid or as any of that. You know, they just left me alone to do what I liked. And that lasted my whole life, and I'm eternally grateful. You know, and there was even times with my dad, who was as old-fashioned, he was an old-fashioned kind of guy, but you know, kids being kids, you say dumb shit, you know, when you don't know no better. Every once in a while, jokingly, you know, make a joke about somebody being gay or say that word, you know, because, I mean, everybody said that word, you know, and be like, hey, you don't say shit like that, right? You don't talk like that. There's nothing wrong with them. If they want to be like that, they can be like that. And this was a dude who came up in a completely different era. Now, he used to use that word all the time. That was his default word for those people. But at the same time, he would use it in a sentence boldly asserting, there's nothing wrong with them. Let them be who they are. A friend came to us one time, I'll never forget, and she was crying because her nephew came out to her and she couldn't handle it. She was weeping real tears for hours about this situation. And my dad had to yell at her, tell her, shut the fuck up. You're literally crying over nothing. It's not your business. And yeah, she had some concerns about what the kid's dad might do, you know, and that really sucks. That is not acceptable anywhere in this world, anywhere on this planet. If you're going through anything like that right now, I feel for you. I do. So like I said, I didn't have to grow up like that, and I'm glad, but a lot of people do. There's a lot of people terrified right now of being who they are. I had a lot of friends who my whole childhood had to hide who they were because it was a very real chance that they might have a place to live, or worse, they might end up in a hospital at the hands of their own parents. That's horrible. It's intolerable. And if you support that shit, I want you off my planet right now. And I don't care. She got no right to be like that and to tell people shit like that. It's fucking wrong. You know, a lot of people say kids don't even know. They're being spoon-fed this shit. I had a guy who I thought was a friend, who's now not a friend. His 12-year-old daughter comes home one day and tells him, Dad, I think I'm gay. He says, you're too young to know anything. Go play outside. He told me that, and I kind of threw up in my mouth a little bit. And I already made the decision that this friendship was kind of on the end of its journey, because this guy whined to me for hours about this, insisting it was the schools and the movies and the TV and the social media. And I'm looking at his social media and I'm seeing his daughter doing all this tomboy stuff, and not the stereotype or anything, but I'm just saying, dude, this is a surprise to you? Maybe you haven't been paying attention, dude. And it goes on every day. Believe me, your kids know who they are. I think the problem is you tell them and you don't ask them. And when you ask them, you don't listen. I think that's a real, real problem. Because it's hard enough being a kid. I remember being a kid very well, because again, a lot of these memories stick for reasons. And you know, people know who they are real, real early if you let them figure it out and you stop telling them who they're supposed to be. Just let them figure it out. And if it's your kid or your family and you actually give a shit, then you'll accept it and love them for who they are. Not throw them out of the house or put them in the hospital or worse, because believe me, it happens every day. And if you're one of those people, fuck you. I'll say it again. If you're a hateful bigot who would turn on your children or your family or your friends because of who they are, because of who they happen to be attracted to or any of that business, if you're that kind of person who would hate and hurt somebody for that, fuck you. I don't want to know nothing from you ever. Period. End of story. And I'm not going to say I'm a perfect person, because I haven't been about anything. Many times, sitting playing video games by myself. I don't play that online shit. I got no patience for people. But I'll be sitting in my room playing a video game, getting frustrated, you know, and I'll start cursing it out the TV. And once in a while, more than once, that word will come flying out. And God bless her, my wife never once missed an opportunity to say, you know, what the fuck? And she's right. She's right. We've done it. We do it. Not saying it might never happen again, just saying, you know, it's like if you ever saw Chasing Amy, which you should see that movie, it's fantastic, really ahead of its time, but it was just like that scene where Jason Lee's playing the hockey game and he starts doing that, and Ben Affleck's like, dude, what the fuck? So I've been there and done that, and you know, good on her for putting me in my place. And I will say this, and I've said this to her, and I'll say it to you guys right now, I would never, ever, ever say that to a person. Right? The only time that's ever come out of my mouth is in private at the fucking TV, and that still don't make it right. But even in my dumbest moments, I know better than to walk up to a human being and talk to him like that. I won't even talk to him like that on fucking Facebook. I think that you people got really comfortable not being punched in the mouth for the stupid, hateful garbage you say. And when I see stuff like, you know, hey, maybe you should just check out, it ain't like anybody would care. Man, you're lucky that you don't say shit like that where I can hear it. That's all I gotta say. I'd fucking end you. I'd end you. Those people are my family. Those people are my friends. Those people are people I grew up with. And I ain't gonna tolerate that shit. Never have, never will. So we're just about done with this wonderful month of June. I want everybody to keep having a good time. I want you to have a good time your way. Don't let anybody tell you it's the wrong way. And if they do, you got my permission to fuck them up. Tell them Rikki Roxx sent you. Peace.